Hello everyone, my name is Anna. I was the lead developer of Portal Stories Mill, and I saw this thread on Reddit here again, asking for feedback about level design. So I guess I know a little bit about level design after doing Mill. So I've not played these yet, so I'll just play through them first, try to solve them, and then maybe try and analyze them later on.
Dave Johnson here. Just want to let the cafeteria staff know to lay off the Soylent Green. I'm holding a memo from the president, and it turns out that Soylent Green is, let's see here, doubling in price. Now, listen up. I don't care how good people taste. This stuff's costing me more than lobster, so we're going back to fish sticks.
This is an interesting layout where you already have this cube available. I have no idea if this is intended or not. Like, I'm assuming that, like, it's not completely intentional here, because, like, it either requires this cube throw or, some really precise timing, I guess. But maybe it is. Oh! And this is quite annoying, if that happens. I guess this does work. Quite alright. Okay, it was stuck there. That's portal physics. Impossible events. Okay, so if I actually take a closer look at what we can do is we have this bull catcher here that allows us to get this vertical thingy, light bridge, which we can use to shield ourselves from turrets, and eventually we have to like use the laser to do things. I do feel. Oh wait, we can actually start there. I did not even realize this. That's some very close timings. Oh, and there are more buttons here. It's a time thing. Slightly better timing if I dispense the bull first. I have no idea what that does. That gives me that cube, which is fine, that's what I need. So I can now walk to the exit. So there is something that went wrong. I'm just gonna enable cheats here. This would allow me to block myself in mid-air. There is another funnel here. I'm not sure that, like, because you can, I guess, do this and then jump down here. But, like, this doesn't really add anything. I don't see, that's, well, maybe I can catch it there, but. And then you have a timer here, and then you have a faith light here. Yeah, I'm not sure what the idea there is. It was the ball. Let me just catch the ball. But like, the problem I have in this level is, what's really good is that, like, it's obviously initially clear, like, hey, this is the exit, there are turrets and there's a laser, so that's really clear. And let me actually restart the level.
Dave Johnson here. Just want to let the cafeteria staff know to lay off the Soylent Green. I'm holding a memo from the president, and it turns out that Soylent Green is, let's see here, doubling in price. Now, listen up. I don't care how good people taste. This stuff's costing me more than lobster, so we're going back to fish sticks.
So this is quite obviously, like, this doesn't work. They have some strong knockback.
Let's see here. Doubling in price. Now, listen up. I don't care how good people taste. This stuff's costing me more than lobster, so we're going back to fish sticks.
I'll quick save here again, so in case I die again. Yeah. So there's blue gel available here. I'm still not sure about these lifts. I am assuming that, like, this is intended. If this is intended, like that's something that happens. With just the physics. Like, I'm actually really bad at, like, platform games in general. So this kind of stuff is fairly hard for me to pull off, but, like, someone who's actually, you know, halfway decent can probably, you know, jump this first time around. We have a cube here. I'm assuming that this is the first step. But as I was saying, when you walk into the chamber here, it's immediately clear, like, this is the exit, these are the dangers, this is what I need to use to get rid of the danger, and pretty instantaneously as well, you see the cube there. I'm assuming, actually, that I need blue gel here. And then I can bounce from there, but I didn't need that. Oh, because I actually portaled over there in time. That was a pretty short time frame to portal. I guess, like, this will just easily bounce me. Oh, this bounces me to the lower platform. Okay. But yeah, by quickly portaling, oh, And I'm assuming now that I have to do this step once more. Let's check this out. I'm assuming that that is what I have to do. Yeah, but I had enough time to walk over there. That's the problem. And I overjumped this again. The portal physics are pretty wonky in that regard. Where like if you jump or don't jump, like that makes a huge difference. Because I did bounce here before, and like, I'm assuming that this is the point here where you like smash your face into here. I'm playing with mouse and keyboard, and as I already said earlier, like I'm really bad at platforming things, so the intended solution, this level would be impossible for me. Like where you smash into here and then you repeat what I did earlier here to get the cube, and then you get this. But this timing window is really, really tight. One rule of thumb we use in Portal Stories Mail is take the time we need and then another 3 seconds. That way, like, mistake, it's not a problem. And especially, just grab my Xbox controller, especially, like, if you're playing with a controller, like, your turn ratios are just way, way worse, so with a controller I would never be able to actually make this. It's a choice some people like, in the very tight timings, but you know, it does influence your potential audience, really. But the biggest problem I have with this chamber is like there are various sections, and it's not clearly labeled. Like, it doesn't always have to be, but like I can start with this area, I can start with that area. It's a little bit of figuring out, and specifically in this area over here, there's a lot of buttons, and my first time around, I did not use this section, or the blue gel, or the light bridge at all. That's things that, like, in play, which, like, my goodness, we've had levels in Mel that undergone literally tens and ten. I don't know, like, some levels have gone up to 40. 50 revisions, and some have been incredibly major revisions where entire sections, or hell, even the entire level has undergone a change. But yeah, that's what I think of the chamber and my problems with it. I'll just happily cheat to the next level. Next, this chamber. Preparing the flight. Like, the name also, like, can help. So, preparing the flight implies to me... Oh, hold on, Cave's talking again.
Hey, Cave, someone's not dancing! You know the law, testing is not a dance exemption. Don't make me call the dance police.
Once again, quick save here. That's a lot of cubes, and there are no cube droppers. That's really dangerous to not have cube droppers. I'm gonna be really stupid right now. I guess I think you get the idea by now. If I do this, accidentally or not accidentally, there is no way I can come out of it again. So yeah, that's slightly problematic. Because I have to get past this guy here, which so in general for cubes, it's always a good idea to actually have a cube dropper, and preferably, in my opinion, also have have a button to respawn it. You can also only do it auto drop, but with the what's it called, with the button, you give a little bit of more of control to the player. Now, I've played quite a lot of Portal, so I'm assuming now that I have to do this and bring this cube along. That's just an assumption that I make. I have no idea if that's right or not. But... right. Prepare to fling. Like that's the name of the level. So I guess I'll do that. There's a funnel there. That's really good. Now this is a really silly trick. Gel loses momentum over time. Like that's a quirk of the engine. Like it's, you know, most people won't know about it, but you know, it's a thing you can exploit to like get gel there. It's another really funny thing. The way the gel works is it actually doesn't base it on like how fast you're going, or like doesn't like, well, the way it works is that it bases the speed based on the time you've actually been on the gel. So if you crouch on the gel, you actually get way more momentum. This is really good, by the way. You could make it really punishing by doing this with water, but what you did here, you can just portal out of it. Is way better in my opinion. So I need blue gel there. So I need to get a cube over there, which is gonna be interesting. Nope. And I am assuming that this is where you want to get the gel. Yeah, you have two big areas. This is where the entire ramp is gonna be. What does this button do? This disables that. Okay, so I need that, obviously. Let's go here. That gives a cube, okay. And then that disables the first one. That disables the second one. And then, oh! Whew! Right. Okay, so it has to go back again? Nah, let's have a look here. I could have, like, actually shot that portal before I went. That would have been way easier. But I can do it this way. Right. The thing over there. Let's go through here. Okay, this gives me blue gel, and I'm assuming that I need to do... What the? Oh, it's only a blob. Okay. Generally, I expect, like, these buttons to actually give a stream, but that's alright. There's nothing really up there, so... Interesting, interesting, interesting. Oh, wait, I can portal there. Okay. I did not see this area in the first place because I was really focused on getting over there. Now, this is interesting. This gives me a little bit of gel, but not much. If I... You blocked off the line of sight here, so I can't or can I? I can, okay. I can get back up here, but this doesn't really do anything for me, because I need to get a portal there and have speed at the same time. That can be potentially really dangerous. I just realized. This is not gonna help me, is it? No, not at all. I can just do that, maybe. Just bounce. That would maybe help. Oh, that was the wrong portal. The big area of the glass should have given it away to me, because like if it was a fling, it would have been bigger. But yeah, I think this is a way better map compared to the previous one. I didn't need the extra cube here, and like ideally, if I would make the test chamber in hammer, I would have added a door here to really separate the two different rooms from each other, because like they don't have anything to do with each other. So yeah, here the cube drops are really important, and personally I really dislike the one high. It feels somewhat claustrophobic. So personally I would make it at least two blocks high, even though like it doesn't really matter. Gameplay-wise, it feels better in my opinion, and cube droppers preferably three high, so you can't, because you sometimes can break the cube droppers by shoving the cube back in. So yeah, this was alright. I really enjoyed this. This section here really reminded me of the co-op course. I assume that like this wasn't fully intended the way I did it with you know, going around here and just funneling the cube out. Um, let's stop. Oh, fuck. I died. Let's get to this section again. Like, this is also timed, but, like, you know, there's margin for error, which is nice. Okay, so now I go up here. Do I have to do this like super speedy? Oh no, I can just grab it. Okay. Like that's like another thing. This is the fault of the PTI editor, but like this faceplate here has the arrow forward. So, and like it's angled in this direction, so I'm assuming that the cube will fly straight through. I wasn't entirely sure how the hell I would get the cube out, but you know, that's the thing. If I was in Hammer once again, I would have rotated the faceplate towards the actual direction it's firing in. And that's nothing you can do about in Hammer, but it's just a general like game design thing. Yeah, so that's pretty nice. That deactivates those guys. Personally, I would have slightly done this differently. I wouldn't have put all these water sprayers in. I would have made this cube actually activate the orange gel instead. It gives the same result, like you can only solve this part after getting the cube. Takes away a little bit of confusion. Maybe like you could get distracted in the first place by the orange gel, but you know, you can do that while sitting on here, so it doesn't really matter. Like it's still an orange gel dropper and you can still like walk into this dropper and see what it does. Yeah, I guess like you could like paint this while you're standing on this button, but like if you slightly position it differently, that's a pretty good idea, I guess. Like if you slightly change the position, so you can't do that from here, I think that's a better approach. Specifically because the gel can cause performance issues on certain low-end computers. So yeah. And like, it by default here, you're now spawning like the gel particles over there and over here at the same time, so performance could take a little hit. But yeah, overall, it's a nice chamber. This thing here is fun and solid, and you know, this took me a little bit of tinkering. It's really nice. Yeah, that's my comments and stuff. Good luck with the rest of your game design, and yeah, if you want to check out some of the game design choices well, I made, and the people in my team for Portal Source Mel made, you can check it out on Steam. It's free, as long as you own Portal 2, which you do, because, you know, you have a workshop thing. So, yeah, thanks for creating, and I hope you enjoyed my video/commentary thing. Bye.